What's up, everybody? This is Ross with Boxing Pills, and today I have some news about Bob Arum, that if people don't know is actually Tyson Fury promoter, because I mean he had actually quite a bit to say about Eddie Hearn's solo press conference announcing the rematch between Anthony Joshua and Andy Ruiz in Saudi Arabia. That I think that conference, you know, is turning out to be a complete bluff. We still don't know if the rematch is happening in Saudi Arabia or not. And the only thing we almost know for sure is that actually Eddie Hearn lost quite a bit of his credibility. But I mean, first of all, before going into it, please don't forget to subscribe if you like boxing. Subscribe to Boxing Pills. Thank you very much. And now back into the video. Ruiz wins over Joshua. Actually, Ruiz becomes heavyweight champion of the world, right? Correct, but he's not a free heavyweight champion of the world. There is a big difference. Because actually, Anthony Joshua and Eddie Hearn, they chose Ruiz. And what promoters always do, you know, in a contract, in a match contract, they actually put a rematch clause that the opponent, in this case Ruiz, has to sign. And in that rematch clause, it's written actually that Eddie gives power to Eddie Hearn to decide where the rematch is going to be and how much both fighters are gonna take. Pretty much that's it. That's the price to pay that you have to pay when they choose you, basically. The negotiation with the rematch started, you know, Eddie Hearn actually taking the lead, right? And all of a sudden, we actually see Eddie Hearn around two weeks ago, actually giving a press conference, officially announcing that Anthony Joshua against Andy Ruiz rematch is going to be on the 7th of December in Saudi Arabia. What was surprising is that at that press conference there was only Eddie Hearn and a man representing Saudi Arabia, whatever, no fights were there, and on Ruiz's side there was complete silence. There was nothing, they didn't say anything. And after one or two days, Ruiz came out and said, you know, I haven't signed anything, and the rematch is going to be on my terms, maybe in New York. So that doesn't make much sense, right? If you are Eddie Hearn, you don't go having a press conference in front of everybody if you haven't spoken with Andy Ruiz first, right? So why did that go and make that press conference? And then, I mean, why did Ruiz just came out and say, I haven't signed anything, right? I mean, maybe that's the thing that will make probably most sense. I don't know. I'm open actually to suggestion, guys. Is that actually, you know, Eddie Hearn, you know, had the idea about Saudi Arabia, maybe called actually the promoter of Andy Ruiz, and he actually said, now, you know what? You know, maybe we can make the rematch in Saudi Arabia. It's going to be lots of money. You know, they are going to offer this and that. And they say, yeah, no, it's okay. I mean, why Saudi Arabia? It's very good. You know, why don't you send us the contract so we sign it? You know, and they said, okay, I mean, can I go on with the press conference, doing a press conference? I say, sure, why not? That's at least what I think. So actually, he went on with the press conference, but they didn't sign the rematch clause. That will make a lot of sense, guys. No, it's like a poker move. Like, they send ahead Eddie Hearn saying that actually they were going to sign the contract. Eddie Hearn does the press conference. They don't sign the contract. And, I mean, do they have to sign? As I said before, the power is on Eddie Hearn's side, right? Correct and not correct. Because here it's also, no, what Bob Arum has actually to say. Bob Arum has been around being a boxing promoter for more or less 50 years, you know, since, I mean, when Eddie was a kid, Bob Arum was already being a promoter. And what he told is that, okay, the rematch clause gives power to Eddie Hearn, right? But not if the rematch is on a dangerous ground, like can be actually considered Saudi Arabia. Because think about it, I mean, Saudi Arabia is not a safe zone. So it doesn't matter what is written in the rematch clause, right? If the rematch was going to be in Cardiff, Andy Ruiz was going to be obliged to go to Cardiff because Cardiff is safe. There are no worries going to Cardiff, right? But if the rematch in Saudi Arabia, Eddie Hearn loses his power because it's kind of, allow me the term, war zone, right? So it's not a safe zone. And if Eddie Hearn goes to, and if Andy Ruiz goes to a judge, whatever judge is going to grant him exemption, okay? Probably they knew that. So they send away, they send Eddie Hearn for the press conference. And then they say, hey, even if in the contract is written that you decide, you cannot decide for Saudi Arabia, but now you have already announced. So probably your credibility is fucked up. What do you think if we negotiate this another way? And maybe probably what's going to happen now is that they have actually, as we say in my country, the knife on the handle side. So they can actually push Eddie Hearn to say, yeah, you know, we want more money. So we're going to go to Saudi Arabia, we fight. Or if you don't give us more money or whatever we want, we're going to push the rematch to New York. Or to somewhere else. And anyhow, if the rematch is not going to be in Saudi Arabia, you lose your reputation. So what do you want to do? And actually, no, Bob Arum really said it very well. He shouldn't have chosen the rematch in Saudi Arabia because, of course, I mean, that's not a safe zone and doesn't matter what's written in the contract. And that contracts don't fight. Contracts don't fight. They don't go to war. So he said, if I was Eddie Hearn, I wouldn't have gone on with an official press conference without having both of the fighters signing the contract. That's key because also Bob Arum said that in order for what has happened up until so far to happen is because Ruiz didn't sign the contract. So if the contract was signed, then Eddie Hearn would have had all the reason in the world to go on with a press conference. But as I told before, as I think happened, is that they say to Eddie, we are going to sign the contract. They sent him ahead with a press conference. They went back and say, no, we sign only if you satisfy our needs, you know, in terms of money or whatever it is. So that actually tells pretty much all. And I think Bob Arum is right. You know, contracts do not fight. And I mean, Eddie Hearn is supposedly to be an experienced promoter. And this thing, things like this shouldn't happen. So thank you very much for watching the video and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. Don't forget to subscribe if you like boxing. Ciao.